Well, hi there. So, tell me a thing. Don't you like to party? Sure you do. Surely you must like to be the center of attention, don't you? No? Well, come on here. I have some glasses for you. Now pick them up. Come on. Yeah, that's it. Now put them on. It's not going to hurt. Hi there and welcome back to another video. Today we're going to look at these glasses I purchased on AliExpress. I don't really have any use for them, but I thought that was kind of interesting. They have Bluetooth, so you can control them via your phone. There's an app for Android and iOS even, so you can make your own graphics on top of this, and they can display a lot of different things. You can program them. They came in this quite nice looking box, really sturdy. I remember in the old days, Apple started putting electronics in proper boxes so it looked nice, but these days you see a lot of other vendors doing that as well. It came with this, it's a very sturdy pouch, so if you're not going to use them for the glasses, you can use that for something else. And a USB charging cable and a manual. Not a bad product. It tells you, they call them shining glasses, product model SL-009. So if you want to find them yourself, you can Google that or search that on AliExpress. They tell you they take 3 hours to charge them and use time 5 hours, although that will depend on the animation patterns you are running on it and the intensity you set the light on. It also tells you the rated capacity is 700 milliwatt hours. Long life battery, 500 cycles or more. A lot of information here. I think that's really interesting. They go into great detail about what's in these glasses, really. So I'm going to pile them on now. And after I had a sip of my secret sauce, they have a button here. And if you press that, it starts telling you what the battery level is. As you can see, it was a bit low. We can connect the charger in a little while, so you can have a look at that. And they start with this animation pattern. And then you can cycle through them. It has quite a few number of them. And yes, you can also control that using your phone, which pattern you want it to display. I think it's a bit way down here. They have a built-in Halloween themed one. Let's see, this one's quite cool actually. So yeah, this was the one. So many different patterns to cycle through. Depending on what you feel like showing. It looks really good, I think, really good. Heartbeat, I suppose. Yeah, it's a pumpkins. Suppose that would be good for Halloween, right? So, in order to get the full, what should we say, the full experience here, you can pair it with your smartphone. I'm going to show you that right now. So there's a new version of the software, but I'm not going to upgrade it to that because I just want to make sure that this is a quiet in Danish. I just want to make sure that it works while I'm recording it. But I actually wrote a new update to it, so yeah, it's a it's not just something they program it and leave it at that. So you can make a, let's take some Martin Fantastic YouTube channel. Send. Okay. Is this still recording? Yeah, so you can then program different things here, and you can say it should be scrolling, and you can set the speed, and you can also set this should, what's the background color, what should that be? Should that be different? Can you see that on the camera? Maybe I'm like this, and surely you can see it. So, and then it has a number of other features. I think this was the drawing one. Yeah, you can choose from some animation. Some of these you already have seen, so you can just select them here on the phone right away, so you don't have to cycle through them. There are some static ones you can use as well. DIY, yeah, this is where you can draw your own and show your skills or lag off. So you can see it comes up on the screen right here. Now, if only I was a person who attended parties, I'm sure I would use these, certainly at our company Christmas party, although all of these things have kind of been, they're not going to happen this year, are they? Let's just stay at that. Not go into details about that. They also have a feature to synchronize with the music, but I don't think I can do that right now. Well, I can do it playing Frank Sinatra. Of course, I can play the music, but they also can use the phone as a microphone, so they will react to the music that's of this whatever noise there is in the room you're in. So they're reacting to that. That's a thing they can do as well. So yeah, quite a lot of features on these. So one thing you're probably going to ask is, that's all fine and stuff, but can you actually see something through them? And you can, not a lot, but I don't know if you can see this. There's a tiny slit here when you can look, where you can look through them. I think we can see there's a light through, just not a lot. And of course you cannot adjust them, so. And I have a really big head, so they don't fit me there that well. I can use them, but not that good. I have to put them at the tip of my nose, and then they're quite far from my face, and I can't see a lot. I think if you have a smaller head, it would probably work better. But then again, my head is also, I think when I'm buying bicycle helmets, I'm going for the, it's not just extra large, it's the ultra extra large I'm going for, because if I need them to fit, sometimes extra large will fit, but mostly I need ultra extra large, because that's the sort of person I am, huge. So they're quite hard to see through. You can see a little bit through these slits, but I ended up mostly looking over them or under them, so they're not massively great. I think you have a fifth of your normal field of view. I think the smaller face you have, the better. So yeah, they have this rubber padding here, so not too uncomfortable to wear. But I don't know if I would be wearing them all night. I think I would run into problems with my with seeing stuff, you know. So that's LED glasses. I don't know. I don't really have anything else to add to this. So. You can go buy them if you want to be the center of attention. No, they are not virtual reality, they are just added reality. So yeah, that's all for now. Until next time, have fun on the interwebs.